Namaste, all my dear students. Myself, Dr. Hemant Vyas, Associate Professor and Head of Department of Surgery, Faculty of Homeopathic Science, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. In today's session, we are going to discuss about acute suppurative otitis media. So let's study the definition. Acute suppurative otitis media is defined as suppurative infection involving the mucosa of middle ear cleft. So by convention, it is termed acute if the infection is less than 3 weeks in duration. So this is the middle ear cleft, which includes Eustachian tube, middle ear cavity, and mastoid bone. Etiology. The ASOM or acute suppurative otitis media occurs more easily in children and infant and in winter and spring season. After upper respiratory infections, the chances of ASOM are increased. Measles, diphtheria, tonsillitis, chronic infections of sinuses, and nasal allergies are other predisposing factors responsible for acute suppurative otitis media. Now, causative organisms of ASOM. Three main bacteria which are responsible are Streptococcus pneumoniae, Haemophilus influenzae, and Moraxella catarrhalis. So these three bacteria are found in majority of cases responsible for ASOM. Other bacteria are Streptococcus pyogenes, Staphylococcus aureus, and Pseudomonas aeruginous. In 18 to 20% cases, there is no growth found. Some viruses like RSV, influenza, rhino, and adenovirus are also responsible for ASOM. Now let's study from where this infection can reach the middle ear cavity. So routes of infection. So basically there are three routes through which the infection can reach the middle ear cavity. First is the Eustachian tube route. We know that the middle ear is connected with nasopharynx through Eustachian tube. And through the Eustachian tube, the infection may go directly to the middle ear cleft. The other route is through external acoustic canal, and this happens if there is perforation to the tympanic membrane. Or the third route is blood-borne infection. So infection can directly reach through blood vessels. First route, through Eustachian tube. It is most common route. Children are more susceptible to this. Eustachian tube in infant and young children is shorter, wider, and more horizontal and less stiff. So that's why the chances of infection are more in children. Large adenoids can interfere with the opening of the tubes. Immune system is also not fully developed in children. That's why ASOM can easily occur in children. A small tube connecting the middle ear to the nasopharynx. It functions regulate and equalize pressure of middle ear. It prevents fluid from accumulating in the middle ear. Protect from nasopharyngeal infections. In children, Eustachian tube is at an angle of 10 degree, while in adult, it is at the angle of 45 degree. So, Eustachian tube is quite straight, and that's why infection can easily travel in children. Isthmus is a narrowing in the Eustachian tube at the junction of cartilaginous and bony part, and it is only present in adults. So in this diagram, we can see the angle, which is 10 degrees in infant and 45 degrees in adult. That's why chances of ASOM increases in infants. So infection through external acoustic meatus is associated with tympanic membrane perforation. Example, tympanic membrane trauma, insertion of tympanostomy tubes or tympanometry, meningotomy can lead to ASOM. Now we are going to study ASOM in detail. So there are 5 stages of ASOM in which we are going to study. The first stage, which is called as catarrhal stage, also called as stage of congestion. So in each stage we will discuss pathology, symptoms and signs. So the first stage, which is called as catarrhal stage, it is also found that there is occlusion of Eustachian tubes in this stage and congestion of middle ear as far as the pathology is concerned. Symptoms: there is fullness in ear, severe pain in middle ear which is aggravated at night, deafness, tinnitus, autophony. These other symptoms are also found, and the constitutional symptoms like fever and malaise can also be found. Signs: there is retraction of eardrum, cartwheel appearance of tympanic membrane, and tympanic membrane becomes completely red and light reflex is lost. So in this diagram we can see the congestion and cartwheel appearance of the tympanic membrane. This cartwheel appearance is seen because of the radiating nerves, the radiating arteries or blood vessels which are found on the tympanic membrane. The exudation stage is the second stage. The pathology shows exudation of fluid starts in middle ear cleft. It pushes the eardrum laterally. The symptoms, there is increased intensity of all symptoms that were present in the catarrhal stage. The sign is bulging of eardrum and it becomes convex. So in this diagram we can clearly see there is bulging of eardrum and the dome has outwardly become the convex. Third stage is suppuration stage. Pathology: there is exudates which converted into pus. There is stretching of eardrum. Eardrum perforates and pus comes out. Symptoms: decrease in pain and fever after perforation and escape of discharges. Signs: eardrum perforates in antero inferior part. Otorrhea: initially discharges are blood stain. Lighthouse effect: pulsatile discharges. Lighthouse effect is an important effect which we have to study in this chapter. There is pulsatile discharge, that means exudates under pressure comes out synchronized with each arterial dilatation which is caused by heartbeat. Stage of healing. Now the infection clears up. The symptoms like otorrhea continues. Relief in other symptoms is there, and this stage may begin after any above stage, as this is acute suppurative otitis media. So that's why the stage of resolution may start from any stage. The stage of complication begins from the second week. There is acute mastoiditis, facial paralysis, labyrinthitis and petrositis. So these complications can be observed in the ASOM. Now what investigations we suggest to the patient? We suggest test for hearing like audiometry and tuning fork test which shows conductive deafness. Hematological investigations has to be carried out. Bacteriological examination of discharge can be advised to test which bacteria is involved and to test the sensitivity of the bacteria to the antibiotic. Now let's study the treatment. So treatment can be systemic, local or surgical. In systemic, we give antibiotics, analgesic, decongestants, and we advise rest to the patient. Local examination involve ear drops for decongestion, and last is surgical management, which include laryngotomy. So in this diagram we can see this is the diagram of laryngotomy. Incision is given into the tympanic membrane in inferior part. There is placement of a tube with forceps, and this tube remains in place so long as the discharges are completely drained out, and after that the tube is removed from the part so that the tympanic membrane can heal easily. So that's it. Hope you like the presentation. Thank you very much.